When is Windows support ending? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com with an answer for a question whose answer keeps changing frequently and with some big news over the past couple of weeks. Before we get into it, if you're not a patron of Ask Leo, visit askleo.com/patron. They're what make this possible. They're what make this video and in fact most of Ask Leo available for free to everybody. You'll get access to exclusive content for patrons only and an ad-free experience when you're visiting askleo.com. So, when does Windows support end? Well, there are a couple of very simple answers depending on your version, and then things get complicated. For example, everything prior to Windows version 8.1 is no longer supported. Windows 8.1, its support ends January the 10th of 2023. So we've got about a year and a half left on that one as of this recording. Windows 10 is where it starts to get complicated. Every feature release, in other words, these half-yearly updates, they're supported for 18 months. So once a feature release is released, you have 18 months and that one will be completely supported. Now, within that 18 months, there should be two, if not three, newer feature releases that reset the clock. So you get a feature release, you 6 months later get another feature release, and that resets your clock for another 18 months. You get another feature release 6 months later, and again, that resets the clock for 18 months worth of support. If for some reason you cannot update to the most recent version or feature release, then what you have will be supported for only 18 months. Now, on top of that, Microsoft has announced that support for Windows 10, at least the Pro and Home editions, ends on October the 14th, 2025. So that's about 4 years, a little over 4 years from when I'm recording this. That's lots of time. It also tells us, if we work 18 months backward from that date, that the last feature release for Windows 10 will be roughly April of 2024. So Windows 10 definitely has a lot of life left in it. It's not dead by any stretch. But they did announce Windows 11. Now, of course, Windows 11 has no formal end of support date for it. It's indefinitely supported. Of course, certainly there will be an end date someday, but they haven't told us what that's going to be yet. What they have told us, though, is that the feature release model is changing a little bit. Instead of releasing a new feature release every 6 months, Windows 11 will go to an annual cycle. Once a year, there will be a major release of Windows 11. That release will be supported for 24 months, or 2 years. So for whatever feature release you happen to have for Windows 11, you've got it for 24 months. Again, within a year, you should have another one that'll reset that 24-month clock. But we're talking Windows 11 here. That's a long way off. It's not something that the average consumer should really be thinking about right now. It's the middle of 2021 as I record this, and we don't expect to see releases of Windows 11 until the end of the year at the earliest, probably further than that. So focus instead on the Windows 10 end of support dates. Make sure you get the feature releases as they are released to extend the length of life of your Windows 10 as long as possible. Now, there is one question we also need to answer, and that is, what does end of support even mean? I mean, Microsoft keeps telling us that we're going to stop supporting this, that, or the other version of Windows. But what does that really mean? Well, I'll put it this way. Windows XP machines are still running. Windows 7 machines are still running. Windows Vista machines are still running. All of those machines that had the older versions of Windows that are no longer supported, yeah, they're still working. The difference is that they're not getting any updates to the operating system. No bug fixes, no security fixes. So, for example, if a security vulnerability is discovered in Windows 7, it's not going to be fixed. It's going to be up to you to protect yourself from whatever that vulnerability exposes you to. Now, the good news, to extent, here is that this end of support is about the operating system. It's about Windows itself. I get a lot of questions occasionally that from people who are still running Windows 7, for example, and Windows Update keeps running. And in fact, it keeps updating stuff. Well, the stuff that it's updating is not Windows itself. Typically, it's other components from Microsoft, potentially Office if you have opted in for that, but also Windows Defender or Microsoft Security Essentials or Microsoft Security or Windows Security, whatever they're calling it on the version of Windows that you happen to be running, that's still getting updates. That is still getting updates, getting up-to-date anti-malware databases, getting up-to-date changes to the actual antivirus or anti-malware software. That too will end someday, don't get me wrong, but that is the kind of a thing that continues to be updated even though the operating system itself is no longer supported. It's something you need to at least be aware of and understand if you are running one of these no longer supported versions of Windows. It's important to understand because you can either elect to upgrade to one of the feature editions or one of the versions of Windows that continues to be supported, or you can keep running your unsupported Windows. You just have to know that it's unsupported and what that means. And what that typically means is you need to be extra careful. You need to make sure your security software is still supported by whatever vendor that may be and is still getting kept up to date, and that all of your software is still being kept up to date, and that you are basically practicing best practices when you use your computer. But that's all end of support really means. No more bug fixes, no more security fixes. Everything else kind of sort of keeps working, at least for a while. Hope that was helpful. I hope that gives you an idea of what to expect out of future versions of Windows and compared to what you have on your machine right now, how long to expect that to keep working. For updates, for related articles, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/13845. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.